In the early days of the record industry, business was much simpler. In short, the artist made the music, the company recorded the music and sold it to vendors, who then passed the product on to the consumer. On the other side, things were easier for consumers as well. One would go to a music store and purchase a record, take it home, and let the record perform the only function it could, to play over and over again on a turntable. While it can be said that there was a trading and sharing of records between peers, it was on a much smaller scale than we see today. In 2009, business and consuming is far more complex, mostly due to the phenomena that has come to be known as the World Wide Web. With developments in technology, consumers have a broad range of ways to procure music legally and illegally. It is the goal of this short documentary to outline the current situation of the music industry, show how new technologies are shaping the music business, and how internet powerhouses like YouTube and Apple are influencing the future of the music industry. Since the turn of the new millennium, we have seen fast-paced development in technology, especially music technology. Briefly defined, music technology is devices and services that facilitate obtaining and listening to audio content.
So the prevailing application for this music technology is Apple Computer's iTunes Store. Here customers can get what they want for a reasonable price right in their own home. However, despite the success of the iTunes Store and other legal software, the International Federation of the Phonographic Industry still estimates that 95% of all songs distributed online are pirated.
Napster pioneered the newest wave of digital piracy, peer-to-peer file sharing, whereby users of this software upload or rip music, then distribute it and download it illegally. Things have changed since Napster, however. Record companies have filed lawsuits, and record executives have scratched through their skulls thinking of ways to regulate the distribution of their product.
Now, this is a service where you can pay per song or per album using a credit card, and it's very quick and easy. I found my new favorite song by Flo Rida called Right Round. All I have to do is click, accesses the iTunes store, and I can choose to buy the album. In this case, it's just a song. And this is a torrent website called The Pirate Bay, and I have searched for the complete Led Zeppelin discography. Now this is almost 4 gigs of music, and every song, every album, studio album they've made is right here, and all I have to do is click a button. And it immediately goes to my desktop, and now I have the file type that will allow me to download every Led Zeppelin studio album.
The fact is, as our beloved Dr. Strangelove tells us, maintaining control of digital products, in this case music, is a tall order for corporations, and they have had little success so far. However, ideas have come about that may lend a helping hand to those who are frustrated and shortchanged due to the problem of music piracy.
In Europe, internet service providers have been suggesting the creation of community-based networks, where users could share music and other multimedia within the network, but not outside. However, the major flaw in this is that those who do not download music or other multimedia would be unfairly charged for the service. Another solution that has been presented is stated within Lessig's Architecture of Perfect Control, where he says that the only way to control and regulate consumer habits, such as digital piracy, is to centralize and monopolize ownership. However, both community-based networks and centralized ownership of online music is a long way from being achieved.
The future of the music industry cannot be foreseen. However, by looking at current trends in consumption of material produced by Apple Computers and YouTube, I estimate that this future is coming very soon. Here, running now, keep it moving, sunny, don't despair. There's no way of predicting the future, but by combining the lifestyle-based product and marketing scheme of Apple with the need-to-know appeal and broadening landscape of YouTube, you'd create a centralized program where users would have everything at their fingertips, a product not very far from the iPhone or BlackBerry. Run for everything you pray for.
However, to centralize the ownership of online music, like Lesson suggests, all competition would have to be dwarfed and the consumer would have to be cornered. This would prove to be the biggest challenge.
Truly, only time will tell the future of the music industry.